a gang fight here in the corner, everyone would bail out and we'd have a big fight. We'd beat the shit out of one another, kick and punch and shit, and then everyone would take off. Now a gang fight is you pull up in the corner with an Uzi, you spray the fucking corner and you take off. That's a gang fight.
You been a fan, killing shit, still innocent. Big truck and not like a tent. I don't want the job being making sense. I pray to God before he take me this rap shit I made.
Amen.
Start out to be like that. It started out as ways for black men to protect their community, and it spiraled out of control as the movement grew and grew, and as they police and FBI tore the project down. And that's why it's so chaotic out here, because now you got different gangs spread out throughout different parts of the city. It might be rival opposition gangs and they in the same neighborhood. That's why it's a lot of shit been going on. So it's deeper than that. It's not just wilding, you know what I'm saying, just, you know, running around shooting for no reason. That's all they know, you know what I mean? They don't have no parents, all they know is the streets, you know what I mean? So the streets raise them, and that's how they turn out. And that's why a lot of shit is happening now, because they don't have father figures, they don't have no role models, so they turn to the streets.
Try to make sure my niggas don't go broke. Huddle that ass what I want to show for. Said half right now, that's a no-go. You could keep calling, I won't show.
Yeah, this shit been going on since the 20s, man. From the organized crime days of Capone to now. Just the gangbanging city, that's the way it always is. That's the way it's always gonna be. In Chicago for you, though.
We over here look like a whole nother world. We're now in Inglewood. Inglewood, Chicago. We used to it, we've been seeing this. A lot of neglect has come to a lot of major cities when we had the thing that happened with the mortgage industry. All these loans was going on for these non-occupied owners and these stated buyers. A lot of people was buying these investment properties. So when this stuff started turning bad, they got an investment property, they're renting out to a renter, and 9 times out of 10, if it's in the hood, it's probably a Section 8 tenant. So now you have these people in these neighborhoods and they in these properties that's getting neglected from the owner, which leads to the board up houses. But Inglewood was always one of these neighborhoods. It looks a tad bit rougher since the Great Depression of the mortgage industry.
I'm the best that I can be. She is hard when you're trying to make it, when you mold it from the streets. See, my nigga
was a very nice kid. He always wanted to be somewhat like in the limelight, let everybody know that he could be somebody. If he
set
his mind to it.
She holding the family together right now. She the muscle. She say he goes. She don't be liking a lot of that fancy shit though. So she'll, you get a pair of shoes, she'll keep the motherfucker for years. Won't even ask for no shoes. I'm saying, she don't even want me to change the blinds. I try to do all that. She don't want to do nothing. She want everything original. That's just her. She original.
Durk is a loving person. He has a good heart. In any way that he can help you, he will do that.
I used to think my grandma was kind of like, didn't really know. She'd tell me, like, I'm praying for you, all that. I leave out 8 o'clock for school, come back like at 9:30, and be like, oh, they gave me an early dismissal. I got like 2 weeks out of that till she started catching on. Like, hell no. I never thought I'd be rapping, man. I just like, I don't know what the fuck I do right now. I ain't like school, period. So shit, I'm really blessed.
We met at a friend's house. Somebody introduced us, and we just became friends, and it went from there.
It was two ways, basketball or streets. Basketball ain't for everybody, man. My daddy went to the Fed, lost 7 months. So I studied hearing about him and seeing what he do, hopping to the streets. I thought I was like 10, 9.
Big sister, daddy, D-Thang. See, I was locked up at the time, but.
Yeah, he was locked up on this pitch.
Right, little sister.
When we went to go see my dad this time. You was locked up this time, too. He was locked up both times, man. The fuck? That's my dad doing life right now.
D-Thang, you know what I'm saying? That's his older brother, you know what I'm saying? That's my best friend. We all kind of grew up together, you know? And basically, like, we just embraced Durk as our own little brother, you know? I don't got no real little brother, so it's kind of like I cuffed him as my own, you know?
I ain't know I'd be rapping this shit.
I worked for a call center, and he worked for a factory, and I was pregnant with my son, and we were just trying to get our life in order to take care of our kids. It was a struggle. We used to scrap up money to go to the studio and, you know, do videos.
And that's how this shit really started, just like this and other neighborhoods on the rap and the records, you know?
I was just playing around. We put out the song, I'm a Hitter. 10,000 views was a lot back then. 5,000, 10,000. Just kept going up to 50,000 and shit. So we like, man, we gonna start taking this shit serious.
Me and my homie SB and Chino, we was in Iowa hustling and shit. We saw his YouTube and shit. He just like, damn, this shit, he was just doing it for fun. And we just went to put the money behind it.
We took it serious, and that's what it is right now. I wasn't really taking it serious at first.
His name was half out in these streets. It just took heed of it.
We realized that Durk had a, you know what I'm saying, he had a little gift, you know what I'm saying, he could flow. And so we just basically pushed him to do so.
It's no secret, Chicago is named Chirac. That's the nickname of Chicago, and it's Chirac because the murder rate in Iraq 1 year was lower than the murder rate in Chicago. So that alone draws a lot of interest of people wondering what is going on in Chicago. Why is all these killings going on? Who's doing the shooting? You know, why is all this violence happening in Chicago? So it draws attention to Chicago. People want to know what's going on. And of course, with hip hop and the essence of hip hop, the art form, it's always been a person able to speak from the streets and give their perspective of what's going on in the city. So that alone led a voice to be heard from Chicago. Now, who's the guys to speak? It's always the youth. Who's most of these murders happening with? It's the youth in Chicago. So now everybody want to hear what they got to say. They're talking about it in their songs. You hear it in the slang. You hear it in the stories they're telling. But people want to know what's going on. What's led to this?
Project's gone, shit. They knocked the project down.
It hurt a lot of motherfuckers because the feds came and snatched everybody, you know? Motherfuckers got hungry and got to doing all kind of shit.
Gotta feel survival.
No one like that at first. We all can walk to the store, play ball in the park and everything. That shit over with now. There was more structure with it. Like, he get into it with him. So why our big homie go over there and be like, man, we finna get this money, man. Tell him to chill out next time, won't be no war, you know what I'm saying? But everybody went to jail, so everybody want a name. You a nobody, you kill him. Now you a somebody. Now everybody scared of you. Everybody want that type of name. You waking up depressed, feeling like shit. You could know you can just go kill him with all the money. Now you got a name now. You extorting motherfuckers. Now motherfuckers give you money off the strength of your name. That's how it works over there. Yeah. A lot of bullshit.
Motherfuckers just trying to fit into something. Like, bro, motherfucking think they don't want to be no lanes out here. Man, fuck that shit, man. I ain't never shot no nigga. I ain't no motherfucking lane.
Keep your eyes open. Watch everybody. Everybody up. Stay with the squad. Everybody up.
Keep your head up.
Look, the Jacks on their way
to the boys.
We a fan they have.
as just a normal damn Chirac, man. Young nigga with a 30 popper in his hand, dreadhead, fucking crime scene. You seen the dead man on my back, crime scene, yellow tape, shooting every day. Police here, well, that's normal damn Chicago. I ain't chose this lifestyle, man. This lifestyle chose me. Back in like 04, I ain't even play with guns, you know? So all my people start getting hit up, all that shit, man. You got to get with it or get lost. I value my life, that's why I keep it on me. I ain't going, man. I'd rather give than receive shit. Rather they family than my family, you know? This shit been like this forever. It's just really starting to get out there like that now, you know? Since all these little kids been getting killed and shit. Man, I lost so many guys to this shit. I'm talking about niggas I've been knowing since yay high. That really fucked my head up, made me look at life like totally different. That shit put a lot of hate in me, just like, man. These streets fucked up out here, man.
It's our coke, that shit came with us. I know what we got bought up, we just...
We seeing this. 13. And with that shit, you get that
and
shit.
And it's a lot of ways to gain clout. Mistaken identity, anything. You ain't gotta do what this is. This innocent bystanders getting killed in this shit every day, man. That's why you gotta keep this up.
You gotta keep something.
I like to keep some big shit in case a nigga try me, I'ma cook his ass.
I think it's season, you know what I'm saying? Shit gonna always get bad and look good and then always bad, you hear me? Because there's different generations coming up. Feel me? So we don't know what's going on with the new generation, how they looking at shit. Like they want to be like the gang leaders. You feel me? I see it really right now getting it's getting bad shit. Cause I wanted to be like my daddy and them. You feel me? They was drugs. They was doing whatever they was doing and gang chiefing and all that. You feel me? I ain't never want to be no a teacher, no lawyer, no shit like that. That's all I knew. So you see it right there. And we from the slums of Englewood. You feel me? Ain't no other outreach. That's why they took that rapping shit running with it.
And Looney Savage, I'm from Sean Money, 6th Night of Austin, Chirac, Illinois. You already know I'm rocking. Niggas been getting killed, all this type of shit. This shit been going on. This shit ain't nothing new. I don't even think about it. My man just called it to the bullshit already. So I'm with whatever, you know? It hurt you when one of your guys died, but shit, that's how this shit go. Shit. I ain't scared of none of that shit. That shit happened, it happened, shit. Oh, this shit forever. Motherfuckers dying for this shit. Ain't nobody gonna get cool with nobody who killed one of their men. Shit ain't gonna never end. That shit gonna be always forever.
All in all, like I'm just the same nigga. You feel me? I'm a cool dude, so I rock with everybody, and I like to see everybody win. So it just made me happy, to, you know what I'm saying? You know, like shit, I was like one of the first ones that put in that work. You know what I'm saying? Broke down the doors so that, like all them could come through and all that. So that's how I look at that shit. So I like to see all the like the young niggas and shit that's blowing up and getting them big looks. I like that because it's like shit I put on for that. You feel?
Rest in peace to Pac, man. You know what I'm saying? That's who, like, we started the drill movement, you feel me? He's the chief. So I started just going hard with the shit, you know what I'm saying? Me as well as others. But I just was like, you know what I'm saying? I was just killing the streets on it, you know what I'm saying? The mixtapes and all that type of shit. And I made, like, everybody started to hear the drill shit. I started, you know what I'm saying, dropping the mixtape shit. Shirak, Illinois, whatever. And then I dropped a song called Shadow, you know, just, you know what I'm saying, putting on for like, for Pac and shit. Then got down with shit. That shit just got big. You feel me? Then everybody started, you know what I'm saying, rocking with it. But it wasn't just me, but it's like I say, like I got that shit out.
Drill is like hype, like turn up. It's got a lot to do with violence. You know what I'm saying? Drill, like get killed and all that, kill you and this and that. So when they call it drill music, everybody start doing it.
It's a way to communicate. It's a way to let people know where your struggle come from and basically your story, your perspective of life. It's tough when we grow up. It's basically explaining what we do every day, you know? Shit. We don't live a life with silver spoons or a lot of money, you know what I'm saying? We gotta make do what we gotta, you know what I'm saying, what we got.
It's organic. It's not no fictional shit. You know, they talking about things that are happening in Chicago. They talking about shootings that do go on in Chicago. What people don't know is it was blocks going against blocks. You know, basically beefing on wax. But nobody knew to the masses because they don't know anything about these neighborhoods. They don't know who's from this hood or who's from that hood or even the name of the hood because it's not a well-recognized neighborhood. Them going back and forth led to hotter and hotter music, speaking about things that's going on in reality. And there it goes, your organic street music.
Back then, all these bitches didn't want me. Now when they see me, they be acting like they know me. Young Savage can't starve, I'm gon' eat. I don't even know what happened to the old me. Niggas talking shit, but they don't want no beef. Chopper hit him, leave his ass on a slow leak. No limit, all these op niggas want peace. And you know I got the squad like Kobe. For real though, they used to call me a weirdo. All of a sudden, I'm all these niggas' hero. Taking off, but I'm about to switch gears though. How the fuck you chopping hard and you still broke? Bad bitch with a bad little walk. I'ma bag that bitch. I ain't even gotta talk. Just spent 10K and I forgot what I bought. I be flexing on haters. Give a fuck what you thought. Money on his head, trying not to get bought. Mm. My youngest doing his, trying not to get caught. Trapping all day with the hard and the soft. 30s in the cut, trying not to get off. Real shit, that's the life of a young nigga. Round, still gotta keep the guns with us. A lot of hating ass niggas and these groupie ass bitches. I ain't tripping because I know this shit come with it. That's about it.
The violence was already here. So with our music, we was just talking about what was going on really about that. And they was putting it in stories, like niggas like really gotta pay attention to what we talking about. You feel me? They gotta really pay attention. When a nigga say something crazy and they be like, bro, what is he talking about? It's really like some Chicago shit, like niggas only know in Chicago.
With Chicago not having a real music scene, at first it was just expressing themselves. Artists was expressing themselves. Having a love for the art form and just doing it, which has been going on here forever. It just never got this much light until the violence started getting at the media, then they started chiming in on what's going on in Chicago. What happens recently is a lot of artists been getting deals from Chicago, record deals, and been seeing some real money. Now, it displays to the youth and from the youth that you can do something positive to create an income for yourself, as opposed to doing something negative to provide an income for yourself. And if you do this that's positive to provide an income to yourself, it's more long term than what you can do temporarily, get some temporary relief. Now, presently, a lot of them is doing it for the income. A lot of them are popping up because they know they can get some money from it now. And they're talented. You know, they're talented. There's nothing wrong with it. You know, there's nothing wrong with it at all. Maybe you got some guy that's gonna pop out that may be the next Jay-Z that we never heard of, but stopped rapping because he didn't see a future with being from Chicago rapping. Now that he see that artists are actually getting money from Chicago and getting exposure they deserve rapping, they may come out, you know, and that'll be great for hip hop.
Broski say, Broski, I'm gonna drop me a mixtape too. Cheeseburgers and fries.
Fly with the birds. Fly with the birds, that I step my end is stupid, but I love flying the spur. When you got money to burn, you can't control how you splurge. The block going bananas every day, feel like the furs. Yeah, coupon lean, swag on mean. What's in my pockets don't like is true religion. The jeans, 50 bricks on the counter, that's a dope boy dream. Don't get the picture, I paint it like a pair of Moschino. Yeah, Molly a shooter, easy a rider, Twilly a hustler, I'm the yayo provider. I got my bitches butt naked, they in the kitchen with powder. Leaving out of that bitch with a half a brick up inside them, I'm going white girl crazy, spending racks on that bitch. All the black girls hating. me, but I don't give a fuck about a chick or feelings unless it's Christina. I'm just trying to make a million off the same old white girl, same old white girl, same old white girl, same old white girl. Put that shit in the pot, wait till the shit gets solid, cook it up out the pot, you chop it and make a profit. Icy Duck, aka Ellie Lawless Inc. Y'all know what time it is. You hear me?
No, I just try to keep shit as real as possible, man. I try to cut down on the lies. You might hear me say something, pull up and something. I ain't got shit, though.
I've been me before that rap shit. So, shit, you know how that shit go. And everything. By me just doing that rap shit, they just seeing me trying to do something good. They gonna get behind me and just fuck with me no matter what. Shit.
I don't really like this rap shit, tell you the truth. This shit stressful, man. You gotta keep your eyes open, everybody try to put their hands in this shit, you know. Yeah. Like after all the work you did, everybody try to come in and get their little, you know, that shit.
Oh,
I'm losing too much sleep.
By you being successful over fuck niggas. Niggas who you was probably fucking with gonna be mad because you successful and go fuck with your enemies. You know? That's what this shit bring.
It's a job to me now. So it mean a lot. Like I said, at first it didn't mean a lot to me now. Now everything I say, it's gonna be in the public eyes, so I gotta be careful what I say and everything. Well, I take it serious now. I'm saying it's a career. It's how I'm gonna eat.
You looking at us. So it's like it's better for like the younger youth and things, you know what I'm saying? People like that. You know what I'm saying? Or talented people. You know what I'm saying? It used to be if you was talented and you was in Chicago, it's like you just got a talent for nothing. Now it's like you have talent for a reason. You can make it out of Chicago.
Y'all got a bunch of cases on our background. If we ain't getting that way through rapping, this is really ain't no other way, man.
Man, the music turn us up, man.
You know?
Turn us up.
We make drill music, but we make squad music. This shit is only for the real and only for the squad.
This is our music, it's us basically shit.
Seconds
of the beat, then going right, cut the beat off and going right.
He not an alley kid, you know what I'm saying? He just got the brains enough to rap and put his words together and make people like it.
I've been to Miami, Denver, Atlanta. Now we go to Atlanta, we turn down all the clubs.
Deck chopper, make them dance. Make them know that I'm the man. They know that I got bands.
Ryan foreign in the land, Saudi talking, cause who I am, money stacking.
I ain't really expected to take off, but they had YouTube, they had WorldStar start taking off. Bands, deck chopper, make them dance, bitches know that I'm a man.
stuff last year. With this rap stuff and with the baseball stuff, like we be making projects and stuff. I'm gonna have shows, man, on the road and stuff. I think this is my last trophy I get, this one here.
Everybody got they said they doing that over there, doing this over here. I ain't trying to be like nobody, I ain't trying to copycat none of that. I got my own style. Young niggas do it, ain't really a lot of young niggas like me doing it out there. Made me feel good, cause came for nothing, now I'm something, hella bad shit.
Like, I like spitting real shit, like what's going on right now. My daddy, my family, friends, the judge, the police, everybody hate us. Well, everybody loves us. You gonna hear about everything in them raps.
Thank you. Wednesday.
About this being a new generation, so many young people that run around so wild that it's catching people's attention. They ain't never had no young Chicago rap artist that's catching everybody's ears.
Cause I'm a lady.
Kryptonite. I done been through it all. So all my music is basically me. I grew up a single parent. My mother raised me. My father been incarcerated for 18 years now, and I'm 20. Is incarcerated for murder. I grew up from seeing people get their brains blew out of broad daylight, seeing dope fiends, overdose, all in all. I used to hit licks for a living, and like, I used to fight every day. I used to play with guns every day. Like, I used to go to jail at least two or three times out the week and get out of 3, 4, 5 hours and go back to jail and do the same thing again and again and again. And like, one day Block called me up, cause that's my blood cousin, you know. He called me up and was like, I'm ready for you to lead this lifestyle alone. Come get in the lab. Since I got in the lab, it changed my life.
I say, I could've went to school for real estate. I put bitches up in their place. See, all my hoes be down to spray and they don't even carry mace. But keep that on the low, cause I'm supposed to be this prissy bitch. But all that extra token get you touched without my fingertips. Anyways, family in your hood blowing dope. I had your nigga face down like he arrested on my float. I'm on that bullshit. Tell him I got the power, call me Austin. I'm known to be the bomb, but no, I am not from Boston. Midwest, bullshit. No plans of retiring. If money grow on trees, then I'm loving this environment. Bitch, you know I'm paid and it's just way too much to handle. Your career's about to flop and might as well call it a sandal. I'm throwing on my Ray-Bans, now everybody tenant. I'm the hottest thing smoking and your blunt's already finished. I got blunts up in rotation. They gon' dread me like Jamaicans, but they'll never catch me lacking. Wanna verse, you know I'm taxing. Bitch, Team G, man, let's get it. Turn up.
DJ Moondog, Notorious Ferris, Lil Durk.
Get in tune, stupid.
OTF, stupid. Only the family. And we off of them fuck boys. Let's go.
The number one spot, bitch, I'm right here. Bitch, I'm right here.
Everything counts. Don't take nothing for granted. Definitely with the shit going on right now. A lot of people drove fancy cars and a lot of motherfuckers sold drugs. I'ma start this rap shit off. Don't put on no front, no for nobody. I am what I am. Shit. I'm a leader for anything, shit.
I've been shot 5 times on the street, so I done almost lost my life, and a lot of them guys know I have, and they know what guy I was, and they know what guy I'm trying to be, and they respect it. We got guys and like from every area who can go out there and stop almost anything on the front line. I ain't going over there making them stop shit. I'm telling them what's the consequences if they don't stop? And why should they stop, man? And majority, I've been on top of my game. I've been stopped a lot of mediations and conflict resolved. Maybe my brother who got shot, and if they see me like not retaliating, they won't retaliate. I'm trying to end it and stop it, even though it's hard. It'd be hard for me, like, cause I just had a crazy situation. My little brother was shot at, and people who know me know like that I would have been over there trying to hurt somebody, but to see me trying to stop it, you can't do nothing but take your head off to me and stop it. You know, cause maybe 2-3 years ago I'd have been trying to get my little brother lick back, but now I don't want to get his lick back. I just want them to see that we're in a lose-lose situation. We only lose now.
I live for violence. I was a hardened gang member. I went to prison based because some guys, I'm not going to say I didn't do what I did, you know, because I did do it. But I got with some guys that was, you know, from another area, and they got into it with some rivals. And then I was accused of killing one of them and crippling one of them. And I just did my time in prison. You know, as they say, I continued my criminal activity in prison. I got locked up when I was 18. I got out when I was 56. And I didn't want to die in prison. When I got to prison, I was like 120 pounds, and it was rough as hell. If you wasn't tough, and you wouldn't fight, and you wasn't willing to kill, then you was in trouble. You were simply in trouble. And when I got there in prison, I said, look, I'm not gonna let nobody harm me. Whatever I gotta do, whatever I gotta do to survive, that's what I'm gonna do. Cause I'm not gonna let nobody harm me. And that's how it was. When I first got to prison, you had to be willing to go the whole 9 yards. It's like guys just ain't being men. I mean, I'm just serious, they just ain't being men. Since I've been out, I done seen how the city looked, and it looked devastated. Back in my day, if they was after you, they came and got you. They didn't shoot in the crowd, they just came and got you. But now they killing kids and it don't make no sense. I seen a lot of young guys come down to the prison. First I thought they was weak. When I realized they got 50 years and 100 years, and they ain't never getting out. And they walk around looking up at the sky. They lost. It ain't gonna pay off. When I got paroled, the state's attorney didn't want me out. Attorney general didn't nobody want me out. But I tend on staying out. And if I can help community in any way, I'm willing to do it. It feels good to be out. It really feels good. And especially to know you ain't going back. It feels good.
Chicago than Iraq and Afghanistan, but over what? Out there, at least they fighting over oil or occupation. Who are we at war with? Chirac is in your head. And a lot of people gonna say you a hater because you don't got low self-esteem, because you don't look at your home as a war zone like they do. But you ain't gotta be like everybody else. And that's why we here, and they there. And how long are they gonna be there? And how long are we gonna be here?
I was really just disenchanted with rap. And I just started thinking, man, the best thing I could do is empower others.
I was one sinner, but God gonna make me a winner. I remember them winners with the guns and the fleeces. With the guns and our fleeces, watching out for the police. But they watching me, making every day a little hotter to eat. So I can't fucking sleep. This great bitch, and you see, she all upon me about this money, cause the bills ain't paid in. Tuition due today. Who would've knew today would be that day that I set it off? Cause I'm lost, got nothing to lose. So I mapped out my best move. I'm a chess dude, coming for your queen. As soon as you hear that doorbell ding, you better let it squeeze. If not, I'm putting you on your knees. While my guys grab everything. 911 emergency, hurry before they bury me, cause I can't sleep.
We dealing with a new generation. These new kids growing out without mamas or daddies.
when your mama gone and when your mama don't give a fuck about you, you know what that makes? A killer. Cause he don't care no more.
Your mama and your daddy died when you was young. Your brother just died, right? I ain't heard that story. That's your most profound rap sitting inside of you. And you talking about killing somebody else.
It's hard. Every day it's hard. And it's
just, why is it hard?
Because I'm tired of living like
you. You got something?
Like I'm tired of it. It's just like, I don't want it. It's like, it's no option. It's just like some days you, it's like you wake up, you want to be that good person, you want to be, and you can be that bad person. And some days it's just gonna give you no option. And some days you just gotta do some things you don't want to do, and some days you just live the life you gotta live. That's why I come here, so I can get away from that.
Do you feel like you learning something here?
Yeah, just make, I feel like it's helping me find out what I want to do, cause like, it's just like growing up with no parents, you just, it's just like, you don't really know who you are some days. It's just, and it's just like, I keep losing people. And so it's just like, eventually I'm just like, it's just gonna be me by myself. And it's just like, one day I'ma just, it's just like one day it's just gonna, I'ma be alone.
You know, you ever heard the saying, pick your battles? I say, scratch that, pick your enemy. Cause when you choose your enemy, you know what all battles is getting ready to come. You ain't gotta pick the battles one by one if you choose your enemy. Like your enemy is the fact that everybody around you is dropping and you gotta beat whatever that is in the life of your family that's doing that. You gotta be the leader to lead your family out of that. You gonna have children one day, you gonna have a wife, you gonna be successful. You gotta conquer whatever that is, man. You know what I'm saying? You could do that. I think about sometimes, like, why didn't Rhymefest pop? I had to be here. And now that God has put me where I need to be, now I can ascend, you know?
Changing, unless niggas need, you know, role models. That's what it is. Like, if niggas had some positive role models, some positive influences, I feel like, you know what I'm saying, shit'll get better. But when all you see is negativity, and you know what I'm saying, that's what you're gonna gravitate to. If you see bullshit, that's what you're gonna gravitate to. If you surround yourself with positivity, then positive shit is gonna happen. But a lot of these niggas, they don't know nothing. They don't know nothing positive, because all they see is negativity. All they see is what goes on in their neighborhood. You feel me? Like, a lot of these niggas ain't never been, shit, past, shit, 71st Street. You know what I mean? Out of a 4-block radius. You know what I'm saying? It's a whole wide world out here. Some niggas never been downtown. That's crazy. You know what I'm saying?
Violence is an American pastime. Violence ain't nothing we really care about, or nothing we really want to solve. Next week is gonna be Louisiana, Lebanon, Detroit, Syria. Violence is something that, like, we love it. Johnny online playing war using racial slurs. He think it's cool because he don't have to put a face with words in the burbs and think my hood is like a movie, but he don't want to see a real nigga hold a Uzi up, blocks getting shot up, shorties rocking locks, serving product, looking like they dropped from the Gaza Strip. Gucci Strip, Prada, your ass will get it robbed if you bring it to Chicago. El Che Guevara, feeling this martyr, mud on my pants, blood on my hands, guns in the van, supply and demand, we taking hostages in advance. I got a bomb and a list of demands. Having sex is violent, being born is violent, living life is violent, even death is violent. You thought you could cheat, trying to die in your sleep, you gonna suffer from cancer and get shot in the street.